We've had the massive casualties, at least 200,000 civilians killed and probably many more. But even now, ISIS is still active in Syria and Iraq. But more importantly, of course, it has spread along with other jihadist groups across the Sahel region and right down Eastern Africa.
Yeah.
So while it seems that things have gone, it's just basically much more complicated than that.
More complicated. 20 years on, are all the outcomes of this invasion bad, you think?
I think very largely they are. One can't avoid that. And the trouble is that both Afghanistan and Iraq were, in a real sense, failed wars from a Western perspective, from an American perspective. I sometimes think that NATO as an organization is rather pleased, at least, that it's back to being involved in a conflict, the terrible war in Ukraine, about something that it understands more. Because it's clear that the NATO as a whole, and the United States in particular, there was a degree of hubris, almost arrogance at the time, after admittedly the massive shock of 9/11, which we'll never forget that. I mean, that was an incredible shock to the United States, just at the time when it was developing what was known as the Project of the New American Century, a unipolar world. So I think one can understand why the Americans did it, but it went far too far, and it's turned out basically to diminish their influence across the region. So yes, I'm afraid it's a sorry tale from that perspective, but of course a much sorrier tale in terms of the human costs right across the Iraq and indeed beyond now.
Indeed. Thank you very much, Professor, for talking to us about this. Paul Rogers, Professor of Peace Studies at Bradford University. Thank you for your time. Well, Iraq is an oil-rich nation, but it struggled to improve basic public services in the 20 years since the invasion. Political instability, endemic corruption, and security issues have all contributed towards the economy being in flux. Osama bin Jalil has this report from Basra.
Basra's famous Italian bridge wasn't here 20 years ago. Neither was the main road that leads to Basra's international stadium. Now the streets are peaceful and there's relative political calm in the city and across Iraq.
We've achieved more than $8 billion of foreign investment up to February 2023. We are keen to achieve major projects. This is all in coordination with the federal government. Lots of projects were completed in Basra related to infrastructure, services, commercial, and tourism sectors.
This oil field is named Majnoon.